this morning is Anthony Brown from NobleOak Life. Anthony, good morning.
Morning, Andrew.
Give us an introduction, Anthony. Tell us a bit about NobleOak Life.
NobleOak's one of the oldest life insurers in Australia. We've been around for over 140 years. Used to be called the Druids Friendly Society. And we've come from that kind of wonderful background of people looking after each other and treating others the way you want to be treated. So in the past 10 years, we've really built the ex-Druids, which is now called NobleOak, into the fastest growing life insurer in Australia, where we sell both directly to customers without financial advice and fantastic personal service, and also through financial advisors through a few of our strategic partners, being NEOS, PPS and Avant under their brand.
Well, just to build on what you're saying, Anthony, tell us a bit more as far as the business model, what your revenue streams are.
Yeah, that's a good question. There's three main revenue streams. The core one is through our direct to customer business that I mentioned, which is NobleOak branded life insurance. So we sell life, income protection, trauma cover and total permanent disability cover. So that's probably our core channel. The second channel is what we call strategic partners, where we white label and develop products through financial advisors. And we have three brand names there, NEOS, PPS and Avant. That's a lower margin, but a high volume channel for us. And the third channel is called Genus, which is our administration business, where we administer rundown portfolios. So we look for portfolios that might need some love and care, and we purchase them and administer them.
How many active policies are you talking about at NobleOak?
We've got over 90,000 active policies at the moment, and we're growing sort of at a very strong growth rate each year.
Well, tell me, Anthony, what's your market share and where do you see the growth opportunities?
Yeah, I mean, we are in a market which we contestable market of around $10 billion, which is the retail and direct life insurance market. The in-force premiums are around $10 billion. Our in-force premium is just over $220 million. So we're just over 2% of that market. And we see the opportunities because we are a niche player. We're quite a small percent of the market. We are growing at a higher rate than the 2%. And really in those two channels I mentioned, the direct and the strategic partners channel. So we see growth in both of those channels going forward.
Are you looking at acquisitions?
Potentially, yeah, we always keep an eye out for acquisitions. So we listed in July last year to raise capital to help us with our organic growth. But also if we found the right opportunity, whether that's a rundown book for Genus or a complementary business that sort of fits our culture and our financial targets, then we've definitely got appetite.
Just spell out for us, what are your priorities for 2022 here?
Look, our key priority is really to organically grow our business, being our core direct business and our strategic partner business. And that's really through keeping our service as strong and as personable as we can. And we have very strong service measures from our customers, and also maintaining a really good marketing presence at a low cost. So it's we understand that, you know, we're getting the return that we require. That's number one. And number two is, and this is important for us each year, is to continually to build a scalable business model. So we invest a lot in our digital platform, which is market leading, but we can't rest. We must continually invest in that and other systems that we continue to scale up. So, to help us with that growth rate.
Good to see you. Anthony, thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew. Much appreciated.